Hi, I'm Budgie Scott. Welcome to Feral Equinox 2018. I'm doing this video in 360 and also 3D at the same time on this pole. Yes, those are silken ears. So yes, you do hear everything. Anyhow, welcome to the con and enjoy my video. Take care.
There you go. There's, I'll get you team three. I don't mind. Oh, right.
It was really popular. And
I really did. I may have to sneak in on this one of these days.
I'm seeing you.
All right. Let's.
Yeah, these guys obviously.
I would ask Disney.
He wants to play, but he knows
all the answers.
Ask, are you okay with just the sound from the laptop? It's pretty loud.
Yeah, I'm good with that.
I have to explain the rules for once.
I have another spiel in years.
Okay.
I'll do the spiel once we get started so everyone gets it. I feel bad because I'm trying to camera now.
So I probably have to stay here.
No!
My camera is a 360 camera.
Oh, it's a 360 camera?
Yeah, it can turn it into the entire room.
Oh, man.
So if anyone has a light finish,
They will stumble in. Once they hear my loud voice, they just kind of like, oh, there's something going on. Happens every time. Like you get like maybe 6, 8, 10 people who want to play to begin with, and then as people file in, you get another 6, 8, or 10. And then yeah, it just very a lot more people come into this panel than leave this panel, which is a good sign. It means we're interesting or funny and not boring. Rapid fire all through all these questions, right? It actually doesn't make the game any shorter.
Mm-hmm.
You guys looking for furry feud? Why not? Are you guys looking for furry feud? Are you guys looking for furry feud?
There is a
FedEx
business center in the hotel.
It's so disappointing. All right. So, are we good to go? A and B. We can do purple hat versus fursuits. How about that?
Purple versus Nurple.
Purple.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Furry Feud.
So most of you have seen Family Feud. We're kind of a spinoff of that, except for instead of, you know, asking boring people, we ask furries these questions.
There is no $10,000 prize.
Even though we are in Canada where, you know, that isn't as much as where I'm from.
Which is Chicago, where dollar doesn't really go that far either.
But for a simple game, we're going to have two members of each team come up here where I'm going to ask them a question. They're going to buzz in. First one to buzz in will get a chance to answer. If they get the number one answer, they get an option to pass or play. If they do not get the number one answer, the other team gets a chance to steal. If they get a better answer, they will get the option to pass or play. Whoever gets to play that question, I will ask them the question. All surveys were answered by 100 furries. The top so many number of answers will be on the board. I'll go down the line, ask each and every family member the question. If they get something that is on the board, they'll come up there, they'll get points for it. If it is on the board, they'll get a strike. Three strikes, and the other team will get a chance to steal unless they clear the board first. So if the other team steals, they will get all the points that they accumulated. If they fail to steal,
this team will keep all the points.
We may double and triple the points at some point in the game. First team to 300 wins. Are we good up there? We good? What did you do? Ignore what time it says on my laptop. That's in Central Time. Don't go by that. You will miss everything this time if you trust my laptop. This panel never starts on time because I'm idiot when it comes to computers. So hey, that's good enough. All right, let's get two people up here. Purple hat and fursuiter, queen, king, prince. S.
Whatever.
And I know you guys are going to have RPG tonight. That's fine. Be nice to each other. All right, guys. 100 furries surveyed. Top 8 answers are on the board. Buzz in once you know the answer to this question. Top 8 answers. Name an advantage of having a beard.
You can save snacks for later.
Page down. Number 3 answer. 2 more will beat that.
You walk at ID.
You won't get ID'd. You're gonna make it look like you don't need, well, again, it's what, 19? Oh, number four, again, you guys want pass or play? All right, they're gonna pass. All right, you guys gotta play this. I had it happen twice at Gateway.
Yes.
All right, middle guy. Middle guy, was it Zen? Zen. All right. We had three and four up there. Food saver and makes you look mature. Name an advantage to having a beard. 3 seconds.
You get to keep a bird in your beard.
You get to keep a bird in your beard. Looney Tunes, it land. All right, all right. You know a lot about beards, don't you?
Oh, yes. Okay, let's see. I'm going to say it keeps your face warm in the winter.
It keeps your face warm in the winter, survey says. Number one answer. You guys can clap when they get a good answer. You can clap. You can boo when they give you a bad answer. Have fun with this. You're not going to hurt anyone's feelings except for mine. But you can hurt my feelings. All right, back to you. Name an advantage to having a beard. 3 seconds. All right, two strikes. You guys can talk over amongst yourselves as to what you think is missing over there. All right, then, two strikes up there. You've got plenty of answers to get from. Name the advantage to having a beard.
You look better.
You look better. You guys like that answer? Is that a good one? All right, number two. All right, let me get back to you.
All right, it is scritchable.
It is scritchable, survey says. They tickle! All right, there you go. You gotta go. Oh, I'm kicking things. Awesome. All right, three more answers up there. You guys have two strikes, though. Name an advantage to having a beard.
It can act as a scarf.
I think that would count as their warm. 3 seconds.
Make you look cool.
They make you look cool! Survey says. All right, three strikes. All right. You guys know the answer to this? There's three up there, that'll get you points.
Maybe.
All right, name an advantage to having a beard.
I would say that it helps you get the ladies.
It helps you get the ladies. Survey says. Yeah, number seven up there. Pass it over here. Give them the points. Or give them the points.
Well, you know why? Because sometimes it depends on which direction your laptop is facing. So that's okay. I'll just remember that.
All right. Hey, guys, what are we missing? What are we missing? You can just shout out the answers.
You don't have to shave every day.
You don't have to shave every day. Anyone else have anything?
Making faces underneath them?
What?
You can make faces underneath.
You can make faces underneath. All right, let's do number five. Less shaming, all right. And number six, none. Skunk, are you offended by this? Five people said that there are no advantages having a beard. All right, let's get two more people up here. People, hit the bell, let's go. Don't fall off the stage. All right. Shake hands, be nice to each other. Top six answers are on the board. Name an issue that may come up when buying a previously owned fursuit.
It doesn't fit.
It doesn't fit, survey says. Number two answer, one will beat it.
It smells.
It smells. Number three answer, you guys want pass or play? All right, they're gonna play. Have a seat. So I'm gonna be mad. So there's still the number one answer up there. If one of these guys says it and you guys don't clap, I'm gonna be angry. But clap for good answers. And you can boo bad answers still. All
right. Right, let's see. Use fursuit. Matted fur.
Matted fur. survey says. Ooh, all right, all right. Maybe an issue that may come up when you're buying a previously owned person.
There's holes in it.
There's holes in it. You know what? I don't want it. Then holes in it. All right, number six. Name an issue that may come up when buying a previously owned fursuit.
It may not look the same when you see it in person.
It may look different when you see it in person. Survey says, ah.
Good answer.
Okay, let's see. I'm going to say, it's starting to rip apart.
Ripping and tearing is already in there.
Yep. Okay,
it doesn't fit, stinks, and rips and tears are all up there.
The tail's ready to fall off.
All right. All right, you guys get a chance to steal the points over here. How many points are up for grabs? 53 points.
Okay, we're gonna go with it never arrived.
It doesn't arrive. That fursuit scam market. Show me it doesn't arrive. Guys, what are we missing?
It's expensive and you can't get it through customs. Oh,
nice. This sounds like a personal tale. Anyone else? Anyone else got anything?
What about a bad reputation?
Bad reputation. Anyone
wrong
else?
Wrong color for your persona.
Sorry?
Wrong color for your persona.
Wrong color for your persona. All right. So what's the number one answer? Stains. Dirty. Oh. Number four. Seller's reputation. All right. And number five. Oh, jeez. You never know. All right. 53, something or other, 76. Let's get two more people up here. All right, guys, we're moving a little bit slower, so let's double the points right here and keep this game moving.
Double the points.
Shake hands. Guys, top six answers are on the board. Name something parents buy for their kids before they go back to school.
New clothes?
New clothes, survey says. Number three answer, two are going to beat it.
A new laptop.
A new laptop, survey says. Ooh, not up there again, you guys want to pass or play?
Play.
All right, they are going to play. Nice that you guys are here. You're a teacher? Oh, if you get any strikes, we are going to roast you. Got a microphone right here for you. All right, name something parents buy for their kids before they go back to school.
Pencil.
Pencil, survey says. Number two answer.
Paper.
Survey says. Number four, all right. Still that elusive number one answer.
Backpack.
Survey says, yay. Be supportive. You guys are Canadian. You're supposed to be nice to each other.
Sorry,
I'm the American here.
All right, two more answers up there. I don't think I have any strikes yet. Name something parents buy for their kids before they go back to school.
Lunchbox.
Oh.
People still buy lunchboxes?
Who eats lunch?
Who eats lunch? Who eats breakfast?
The box eats better than the lunch.
Right. You got it.
Pencil crayons.
Survey says. Ooh. All right.
Shoes.
Oh, that's a freaking good one.
Survey says.
Oh.
Ooh. All right. Guys, there's 172 points that you guys can steal here. Name something parents buy for their kids before they go back to school.
Binders.
To steal the points, show me binders.
Yeah.
All right, 225 points. Guys, we're missing one answer up there. What are we missing? What are we missing?
Rulers.
Rulers. Anything else, guys? Any other guesses?
Cell phone.
Published 2018. All right, show me number five. Books. All right, let's get two more people up here. All right, you guys gotta get back in this. Here we go. Top six answers are on the board. Name a sport that Canada always seems to win gold medal. Hockey, survey says. Number one answer, you guys gonna have to play. All right, we're gonna play. So I'm actually gonna finish this question. Name a sport that Canada always seems to win gold medals in.
Ice skating?
Ice skating, I need you to be more specific.
Figure skating.
Figure skating. Survey says. Number six, hey, it's on there. All right, Bundy. Name a sport that Canada always seems to win gold medals in.
The luge.
Show me luge. Name a sport that Canada always seems to win gold medals in.
Curling.
Curling. Guys, is that a good answer? You think that's a good answer?
Not this year.
I think it's a good answer. Number two answer.
This year, we won that.
Name a sport that Canada always seems to win gold medals in.
Rugby.
Rugby. Is that a good answer, guys?
Maybe.
I guess not. All right, two strikes. They're looking to steal over here. Bungie. Name a sport that Canada always seems to win gold medals in.
Speed swimming.
There are some good swimmers. All right. What we got? We have 166 points. All right, guys. I'm gonna level with you here. You gotta steal these points. If you don't, they take the points and the game. All right, Elliot, up to you. Skiing. To continue the game, show me skiing. All right, guys, what are we missing up there?
Lacrosse.
Lacrosse. Is that an Olympic sport?
I think
it is. Yeah. I hear lacrosse, soccer, anyone else?
Snowboarding.
Snowboarding.
Bobsled.
Bobsled. Show me number four.
Yeah.
It is different than the luge, I know. Yep. And number five. Speed skating. All right, guys, we have... down to the wire here. 225, 242. Let's get two more people up here. I know it's early, it's like 1:30 in the afternoon. All right, guys, we need to get this game over with because we have more teams that want to play, maybe. So we are going to triple the points. No pressure. All right, guys, I'm going to read this one time. Top four answers are on the board. Name the most important piece of furniture in your home.
It's mine?
Yeah, it's
bed.
The bed. Survey says. Number one answer. You guys are going to pass and play.
All
right, they're going to play. Guys, I'm going to read this question to the team one last time, okay? No more reviews. Name the most important piece of furniture in your home. The sofa, survey says. Number two answer.
The lazy boy chair.
Number four, guys, one more answer left up there for you to take the game. Three seconds. Television, survey says. All right, that's your first strike.
Table,
survey says. All right, two strikes. They're going to talk over here. They have. Three seconds. Oh, all right. All right, guys. I'm going to read this for you one time.
Say anything. Wow. All right,
guys. Here you go. The one and only time you get this. Name the most important piece of furniture in your home.
The fridge.
For the game, show me fridge.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Well, guys. What are we missing up there?
Toilet.
I mean, that's important. I agree. I just don't know if more than four people said it. Anything else? You're playing next.
Love seat.
Love seat? I think that would be a recliner. All right, guys, let's find out what number three is. The desk. Guys, thank you for playing. Thank you. Who else wants to play? Oh, wow, look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, you three over here.
Go steal someone. You two. Oh, wait. Hey, where'd Video Monster go? Hey, I want you guys to sit right here because I'm going to call you up later, okay? Tournament champion style. Huh? Do you want to play? Are you too busy? You're too busy. Guys, who else wants to play? We need one more person over here.
Go ahead.
These two can't play because they know the answers. I can't play because I kind of know the answer.
Go ahead. Try it.
Sorry.
You know all the answers?
I know all the answers, but I put the dang thing together. Get up here. All right. Did you replace the question?
Fox Squad? Yes. Fox Squad?
You guys want a team name? Look of Terror.
Bob. Team Bob.
Team Bob.
Sure. All your names are Bob.
Just put a U after that O and Bob, because, you know, Canadian things.
Hello.
Booby.
All right.
We good? All right, let's get two people up here right away. You guys have played this before, right?
Yeah.
Or you at least have seen it on TV, right? All right, perfect. Awesome. All right, guys, 100 furry survey for each of these, so, you know, we'll see what the answers end up being. Top 7 answers on the board. Name something you associate with huskies.
Fluffy fur.
Fluffy fur. Survey says. All right, number 5, you guys get another. There's 4 that'll beat it. So, name something you associate with huskies.
Black and white.
Black and white. Survey says. Ooh, okay, you guys are gonna pass or play. Alright, they are gonna play. How are we doing?
I'm good.
You're good?
A little early for this?
Yeah.
It's almost 2 o'clock.
Name something you associate with huskies.
They're big.
They're big! Hey, big dogs. Survey says. Ooh, alright. Their curl. Guys, that a good answer?
Yes.
I don't
know. Number 1 answer.
What?
That curl, yo. Back to you. Name something you associate with huskies.
Their tail?
That's the curl.
Curly tail.
That curl. 3 seconds.
Their bark.
Their bark. Survey says. All right, number 7. Dang, loud dogs.
Their paws?
Their paws. Survey says. Ooh, we're at 2 strikes. They're going to talk amongst themselves. They think what we got here. There's 4 answers still up there for you guys. Name something you associate with us. Sorry?
Blue eyes.
Blue eyes. Survey says.
Oh, sorry, correction.
What are you doing? Whoop. It's up there. Come on. What are you doing?
So they set up 1 strike.
Oh, they got 2 strikes.
No, they have 2. But they have
1. Yeah, all right. Name something you associate with huskies. 3 seconds.
No.
You get it in time?
Yeah.
All right. Show me snow. Like cold weather, all right. Two more up there, three and four. Two strikes though. Name something you associate with Huskies.
They're lovable?
They're lovable. Diz, Huskies are lovable.
Not lovable enough.
I hate that. I really, really hate this 100 queries that we surveyed. All right, guys. You guys think you guys got it? All right.
Harness.
A harness. Oh, good answer. For 51 points, show me harness. Yeah, number four. All right, guys, what are we missing?
Sled pulling.
Sled, I heard a lot of people say sled. All right, number three. Yep. That's why they won last game. All right, 51. Still the score. Let's get two more people up here. This is a great question. One of our furries surveyed top seven answers on the board. Name something that can ruin a kiss. Tongue. Survey says. Too much tongue, okay. Five are gonna beat that.
Too much saliva.
Too much saliva. Just drooling on their face. Oh, okay. Pass or play. All right, they're gonna play. That was just an awful question. It is both. You know. How are you, man? Name something that can ruin a kiss.
Bad breath.
Bad breath.
Good answer.
Woo! We're gonna train you guys here before the end of the day. All right, number one answer. Great job. Name something that can ruin a kiss.
Like knocking their heads together.
Knocking their heads together.
He's not on there. He ain't wrong.
Just going too aggressively. Wham! Like MMA instead of making out. All right, what's something that can ruin a kiss?
Bites their lip.
They bite their lip. Survey says, oh, two strikes, all right. They're talking about it. They think they know the answer. What's something that can ruin a kiss? 3 seconds.
Bugs.
Oh, bugs.
I mean, yeah, bugs.
You know, you get to the insectorium and you get those flies flying around. Show me bugs. We knew that was going to be on there. Come on.
You got to shoot a shot.
All right. What is something that can ruin a kiss?
A burp.
A burp. Oh. Is that a good answer, guys?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Survey says. Number three. All right, so more points. You guys got 99. We got, okay, audience, what are we missing?
Facial hair.
Facial hair. That beard, yo. Bunty's offended right now. Anyone else? Just screaming out there.
Too handsy.
Too handsy?
Piercings.
Sharp teeth.
So for me, it's not on here, but I would have said direct eye contact.
Oh.
But I know it's not on here. So
look at me when I kiss you.
What's number two? Oh, flatulence.
Oh, come on.
Number four. What's it? You know, when your roommate comes in on you. Number five. Sneeze or cough. And number seven.
Is it?
Yes. That will ruin a kiss. 99. Still a score. Let's get you two more people up here. You guys want some help getting back in this game? You guys want some help getting back in it?
No?
Are you sure? You're supposed to say yes. All right, we're gonna double the points here. Guys, double points, top five answers are on the board. Name an excuse people use not to attend a party.
Someone's in the hospital.
Someone's in the hospital. Sorry, my mom's getting surgery, survey says. All right, number one answer. You guys gonna pass or play? All right, they're gonna play. All right.
people use not to attend a party?
They don't know the person.
They don't know the person. Don't know the crowd man. Good. All right.
Feeling the
ball. Name an excuse people use not to attend a party.
They had other plans.
They had other plans. Number two answer. All right. Name an excuse.
No transportation.
They don't have a ride.
Okay, bye.
We good? All right. We good. Back over. Name an excuse people use not to attend a party. We've got up there sick slash headache, busy slash other plans, and the crowd going. 3 seconds. Alright. Two strikes. They're looking to steal again. They got the team, guys. Name an excuse people use not to attend a party.
They're not dressed right.
They're not dressed right for it. Survey says. All right, guys. There's two answers there that you can steal 126 points.
Right. I'm working.
Guys, is that a good answer? Survey says. Number three. This is just becoming a theme over here. I don't know who you guys are. I just see you once a question. Guys, what are we missing out there?
Diarrhea.
I'm tired. I'm too tired, which is a great excuse for everything. All right, 225. So let's get two more people up here. So maybe if you guys lose the face off here. Because you guys have won each face-off so far.
I know.
Maybe that's the thing. Maybe it's the stealing thing this time.
All right, guys. The points are still doubled. The top five answers are on the board. Aside from Canada, name a country that produces excellent hockey players.
America. USA.
America. Survey says. Number two. One will beat it.
Russia.
Survey says. Number one answer.
Got it.
Guys, want pass or play? They're gonna play.
That was a good one. Got me there.
All right, guys. You got number 3, 4, and 5 up there. Aside from Canada, name a country that produces excellent hockey players.
England.
Survey says. I hear a boo out there.
Yeah.
I love you guys. Get into this game. This is fun. Aside from Canada, name a country that produces excellent hockey players.
Greenland.
Oh,
no.
That was an even louder boo. That's okay. It's nothing personal. It's just people having fun. All right. Two strikes. They're looking to steal.
Again.
Aside from Canada, name a country that produces excellent hockey players.
South America.
That Brazilian national ice hockey team is pretty good. All right.
Really?
All right, guys. This is for the game. If you guys steal this, you win. If not, we go to the next question. Aside from Canada, name a country that produces excellent hockey players.
France.
What?
I think our crowd is genuinely offended at this point.
Get out!
So I'm going to give you some hope here that most of these people, most of the people who answer this, are Americans, so they don't know much about hockey. It may be up there. Show me France. Thank God. You guys are still up. All right, audience.
Sweden.
Whoa, I hear a lot of Sweden out there. All right, see number three. Who else? Any other country, yeah. Sorry? Finland. And finally, Norway. It's cold. I know. That's why I said Norway may be as bad of an answer as France. All right. 225. 130. Let's get two more people up here. All right, guys.
we are running a little long, so we need to get this game over with. Diz, I have an idea to get this game over with. Let's triple the points.
Oh my goodness. No!
All right, gentlemen, top four answers are on the board. If you were arrested and could only make one phone call, who would you call?
My mother.
Your mother, survey says. Number one answer, you guys are going to pass or play. All right, they're going to play. All right, guys, I'm going to read this one last time for the whole team, okay? No more repeats. You get 3 seconds for each person. If you were arrested and you could only make one phone call, who would you call?
Significant other.
Your significant other, survey says. Number two. Mm-hmm. Your best friend, survey says.
Okay.
He's not in jail with you. What the hell?
Teacher?
Your teachers. All right.
There's only one more up there.
Attorney.
Yeah. Your attorney. Yeah. For the game, show me attorney.
Yeah.
You guys are staying right here. Who won our first game? Tournament champions, get back up here. You guys won all the face-offs. I mean, they just were stealing well.
There was a reason I said teacher.
Why?
A friend of mine called his teacher.
There's genuinely worse people calling your teacher when you're in jail.
Whoever fuck we won is by stealing every single one.
Yeah, I was in jail. I was hoping they wouldn't get the player.
You knew it was up there, didn't you?
Yeah.
It's
almost
obvious to me.
Yeah. All right. Guys, turn of champion style. Let's get two people up here. So audience, you're going to help in this game. They're going to help. Because every answer, if you think it's up there, I want you to clap it or cheer. If you don't think it's up there, you are allowed.
Can you do anything? Can you test your button?
If you don't think it's up there, you can boo. I expect a lot of boos. In my room later for the room party. Yes, play on words. All right, I'm sorry. Exactly. See? Good practice for you guys. All right, guys. 100 Furry Survey. Top 7 answers are on the board. Name something you do more often when you are sick. Watch TV. Survey says.
Yay.
All right, number 6 answer. 5 will beat it.
Blow your nose.
Number 3, all right, you guys want to pass or play? They're going to pass, all right. Interesting strategy, Cotton. Name something you do more often when you are sick.
Play video games.
Play video games. How many Brexit survey says? Ooh. All right. Name something you do more often when you are sick.
Sleep.
Sleep.
There we go.
Survey says. Number 1 answer. Great job. All right. Name something you do more often when you are sick.
Take medicine.
Take medicine. Survey says. Oh, okay. All right. 2 strikes. They're looking to steal over here. Name something you do more often when you are sick.
Eat soup.
Boom.
All right. Number 5. I heard that laugh out there, Diz. I like that. We were doing a practice round with this, and that became an issue. Names something you do more often when you are sick.
Visits to the washroom.
Yeah. You need to be more specific.
Yes.
More specific.
Diarrhea.
Get the Pepto Bismol commercial. All right. Except for it's a jingle and not
just a jingle. Crappy answer.
There are three up there. So you guys can steal 67 points. Name something you do more often if you are sick.
Bomb. Straight up just bomb.
Straight up just bomb. Audience likes it. Did the survey like it? Number seven. All right, guys, what are we missing? Two answers up there.
Oof. Oh, jeez.
Just screaming out there.
Cough.
A lot of people saying cough. All right, what's number two?
Sneeze.
Cough is up there, and number four.
Wait,
sneeze. Sneeze.
What?
Oh, sneeze, yeah. All right. The simple stuff. 67, still a score. Let's get two more people up here. Top seven answers are on the board.
I was reading answers.
Oh. Oh, yeah, this question.
Oh, no.
Top seven answers are on the board. Name something you can do to keep your fursuit looking new.
Brush it.
Brush it! Survey says. Number one, you guys can't pass the play. Let me tell you, you have two fursuiters up there.
Yeah.
All right. Furries. Name something you can do to keep your fursuit looking new.
Wash it.
Wash it. Survey says. Number two answer.
That's a good answer.
Store it somewhere nice.
Store it somewhere nice.
Champion.
I was going to give you help. You gave it a straight one. Avoid the rain. Ooh. All right, first strike. Only your first strike. Name something you can do to keep your person looking new. I promise I did not intentionally make this rhyme. I promise. Three seconds. Alex, not on time. All right. All right, Febreze. Two strikes up there. Show me Febreze.
Can I smell?
Yeah.
All right. Number five answer. There's three more up there. Name something you can do to keep your fursuit looking new.
Patch it.
Patch it.
No, I don't think so.
I hear nothing.
No.
Nothing. Survey says. Is that two or three? Two? Okay. Name something you can do to keep your fursuit looking new.
Sorry, no, that is three.
Oh, is it three? Okay, it's three. All right. Guys. For 81 points, name something you can do to keep your fursuit looking new.
Not wear it.
Not wear it.
Ooh. Why would you want to do that?
I don't know, it's kind of inventive.
What?
Oh, wow.
It's like a Dodge Viper. You buy it and you leave in the garage for, you know, 11 months. I mean, yeah, they're morons. It's true, but. All right, got audience, what are we missing?
Let's see. I don't know.
Don't wear it outside.
Buy a new one?
Don't
wear it outside. All right, guys, number four. Jesus.
Okay.
Well, SBA's earlier gave us the
It is true.
Yeah.
They're not wrong, yeah.
And number six. Lint roller, okay.
Oh.
It said that lint roller is lower down.
Let's get two more people up here, guys. Jesus Christ. All right, hey Diz, is this a good time to double the points?
Triple.
All right, you know what? Let's do it anyway, okay? Guys, top six answers are on the board. I actually hate this question. Name something you associate with Toronto.
Furries.
Not a big furry population here. Survey says. Ooh, okay. Something you associate with Toronto.
Snow.
Come on,
Survey
guys.
Says. Number six. All right, you guys don't want to pass or play? They're going to pass. All right. Guys, we're in this wonderful big metro area here in Ontario. There's five things that people associate with it. So, think something you associate with Toronto.
Subway.
The subway, survey says. Okay, first strike.
Thank you.
CN Tower.
Yes.
Number three answer.
Hockey.
Hockey.
Not good hockey, right?
Survey says. Oh, number one actually, answer. Nice job.
Go Flyers.
Well, the biggest losers, why not? Oops.
Name something you associate with Toronto.
Really not a great answer, but homeless people.
Homeless people. Survey says. Okay, so personally, when I think of homeless people, I think of Vancouver.
Ouch. Or right off the Dan Ryan.
It would be as savage if it wasn't true. All right. Name something you associate with Toronto.
Raptors.
The Raptors. They're the best team in the East. All right.
Good answer.
In the
what?
East.
Was that two?
That's three.
Oh, three? Okay. Yeah. All right, guys. Slide over here. Name something you associate with Toronto. That's all I'm going to say. Fire hockey.
The
Air Canada Center. For 94 points, show me Air Canada Center. Ooh, all right. You guys. What are we missing, guys?
Rob Ford.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so I'll let you know that probably about 90% of the people who answer this are Americans. So show me number two. It's in Canada.
Okay.
Number four, the Blue Jays.
Oh, all right, okay.
And number five, filming movies.
Oh yeah,
I can't believe it's not New York.
All right, let's get two more people up here. All right, guys, shake hands. Top five answers on the board. Name something you wear at a furry con and nowhere else. Fursuit, survey says. Number three answer, who will beat that?
A bandana.
A bandana, survey says. All right, pass or play. They're gonna pass. That could be cool. All right, guys, we're gonna have to rapid fire this because we got 5 minutes. So, name something you wear at a furry con and nowhere else.
Collar.
A collar. Number five, it's up there.
Harness.
A harness, that's all right, that's part of collar, so I'll give you another chance. A tail, survey says. Number two answers. Number one and number four still up there. Maybe something you wear at a furry con and nowhere else.
Art of your character.
Art of your character, survey says. Number one answer. All right, one answer left up there. Maybe something you wear. Ears, survey says. All right. Name something you wear at a furry con and nowhere else. Two strikes, they're talking it over here. They're looking to steal one.
Pause.
Survey says. Ooh, okay, three strikes. I don't think this gives them enough. I don't think this will give either team enough to win. All right. Name something you wear at a furry con and nowhere else.
I would say a leash.
A leash. For 152 points, show me leash. Ooh.
Oh,
okay. Guys, thank you. Thank you so much. All right, guys, we're going to get up there.
Pause.
Pause was the wrong answer.
Oh,
all right, show me number four. Your furry shirt. Your furry.
Furry shirt? Oh, well, yeah, it's American fans.
Yeah. That would be great. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you. Everyone, thank you for coming. Glad to go to the room here for the next panel. Well, hope you had a great time. Enjoy the rest of your time.
Hi, thank you again for watching my video in 3D and 360. Hope you enjoyed the coverage of Vernal Equinox 2018 at the Western Harbor Castle, downtown Toronto. It was an excellent weekend, and a lot more busier here than it was Thursday night. Hope you enjoyed, and thank you again for watching. Cheers.